So the answer will be, I guess, 2-chlorofibromo. Fibromo, wait a second. I don't understand my own handwriting at this point.
I guess bromo will be for at first, right? Because it is starting with B.
Oh, yes, sorry.
5-bromo, two
Goodbye.
chloro aniline.
Fibromo 2-chloroaniline. Then second one.
Second one will be 3-butyl pent 4-ene-1-ol.
Three butyl.
Yeah, 3-butyl,
I got three propyl.
like, because like it had the functional group is OH, so it will
Numbering
be
from
starting
OH,
from,
right?
yeah,
Oh yeah, I
and
may.
then it will end at double bond.
Yeah, my bad. I started with double bond.
No, like as sir told, right, the priority will be of functional group if it is available.
Yeah, I, like the terminal thing, I was confused. There's no second carbon. Yeah, okay, I understand now.
The
My bad.
terminal we have just to see like carbon and carbon, from carbon
Yeah,
to carbon.
my bad. I didn't see that. Rest of them are fine.
Rest of them are the points where I have doubts, like the
Okay, then
naming.
let's cover it. Let's cover it then. Let's cover it. Then, like second one, 4,6-methyl, 4,6,2-methyl, not two, 4,6-methyl heptane, if I'm not wrong.
Dimethyl.
Dimethyl, sorry. Dimethyl heptane.
Okay. Is it dimethyl? Because I have taken all the carbons and I have written butyl.
No, like they're not on the same point, right?
Yet, like I checked in the recent, like other answers, sir have done like that only. Like, let me see.
Let me go back and check. Wait a second.
So, any conclusions?
Yes, sir. Like
There's a
we
question
have
number two. Is it butyl or dimethyl?
butyl or but what is the parent chain? एक तो सब्स्टिट्यूट में कैसे लड़ाई हो सकती है? सबसे पहले तो लड़ाई होगी आपका फंक्शनल ग्रुप, देन यू विल हैव द अनसैचुरेशन एंड सो ऑन, राइट?
यस सर,
सो व्हाट इज द फंक्शनल ग्रुप? फर्स्ट टेल मी फॉर द सेकंड वन ना, दिस इज द
सर
सेकंड वन फॉर
ई
यू. फॉर द सेकंड वन दिस वन
No,
और
no,
दिस
sir,
वन
no,
फाइव
no,
पॉइंट
third
फाइव वन
one,
फाइव पॉइंट फाइव
5.51.
अच्छा 5.51, अच्छा 5.51. सो यू हैव ई एंड दिस विल बी, वेट अ सेकंड, सॉरी. या सो दिस विल बी डाइमिथाइल ना, दिस विल बी डाइमिथाइल.
Yeah.
Not only dimethyl, but it will be tetramethyl. It will be like this. All of these are methyl, no? See, you have functional group, which is E. unsat, which is an. Then you have parent. Parent is 7, right? Yes, 7, na? Hept. And then you have substituents. So substituent is what you have. We'll start from here, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So in this 2, you have methyl. Again, in 2, you have methyl. And then in the 4th one, you have methyl. And also in the 5th one, you have in the 4th one, again, you have methyl, correct?
Yes,
yes, sir. Or no? Okay, so what you will do now, you will write the name. See how many methyls are there? 4 methyls. And this is 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl. Right? Then you will have hept. Tetramethyl heptane. 2, 2, 4, 4 tetramethyl heptane. No? What doubt did you have here?
Sir, actually, I combined all of the carbons and I wrote butyl there instead of methyl.
Butyl will be only if you have 4 carbon atoms as a substituent. Okay. So let us say, for example,
I wrote 2,4 dimethyl.
2,4 dimethyl. Tetramethyl. Na? So if there are 4 methyls, you have to position all of them. You have to give the position for each and every substituent, right? So there are 4 methyls. So you should have how many numbers here? You should have 4 numbers here. Even though they are on the same position, then also you have to give the same position. That is 2,2, 4,4 and so on. Okay. So what you have to do? Number for each substituent. Number for each substituent. Okay, so tell me your Salman, what name did you write? 2,4 dimethyl.
Yeah.
Heptane. Right?
Yeah.
Name this one now. How will you name this?
Wait a second, sir. Yeah, this will be also dimethyl, 2,4 dimethyl.
So this is not compatible because see, IUPAC nomenclature isi wajah se hai ki kyun do aadmi ka naam Salman na ho jaye.
No, I understood now what I did wrong up there.
Acha, you understood it, right? And yeah. And for you, kya naam hai aapka? Hamza, you did this mistake, right? So what did you write, Hamza? You write butyl. Sir, you wrote butyl.
I wrote 2,2,4,4 butyl heptane.
Butyl heptane. What did you write? 2,2,4.
4,4.
Then you wrote
butyl.
Butyl. देखिए, एक तो आपने look, you know, this is wrong because it will not even represent any structure because see, you have four position here, but you have only one substituent that is butyl. So this is wrong. So if you have given 4 locations, उस location में कुछ तो मिलना चाहिए ना? Right, so you will have to give, if you wrote tetrabutyl, then it would be something that is debatable if it is right or not. That is another question, but this is not right. So for each substituent, you will have a number, okay? And for each number, there will be a substituent. For each number, there will be a substituent. For example, for 2, there is 1 methyl. For 2, there is another methyl. For 4, another. So 4 methyl are there. That is why these 4 numbers. You got it? Everyone? Hiba, yes, Hamza?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Achha, what about next? Any other doubt?
Sir, next answer will be 4 dimethyl.
4,4, na? 4,4.
Yeah, 4,4 dimethyl pentene.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So I think you got it wrong here, I guess, right? So you didn't write 3, 4, 3 and 4. So this is one carbon, this is one carbon. Let me just.
Oh, yeah.
Got it now?
Yes, sir. I didn't mark the triple bond.
So did anyone have doubt in this? Any other one? Does anyone else have doubt in this? Hamza, Hiba, what did you write,
no,
Hamza?
Sir, I wrote 6-6 dimethyl hept-3-1 and 3-ine.
Hept-3-ine, yeah, that is correct. That is correct. So it will be E and then YN. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And that is why this will be hept. This will be hept. And then you have two methyls. So this will be methyl. And then you have di, because two methyl, and they both are located in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay, so this is 6, 6. Now, this is your, okay, one more thing that I, what wrong was, this will be 3-ine. This will be 3-ine. So 6, 6, dimethyl, hept 3-ine. Okay, this is the name. This is the name. Some people will come and they will say, no, we have to number from here because this is, here it is 2 and here it is 3. But don't listen to them. Don't listen to them, okay? Even though that is also correct, but we will follow one rule. And we will confuse you. What do we follow? We follow one rule, that is functional group. Then you have the double bonds. And after that, you have the triple bonds, okay? So this is the priority order and this is the way how you will number. Even if, okay, if somebody says something now, then just tell them that, this is also right. Just copy this and look up in the internet. So let me just write this. So we have 6, 6. Can you please dictate it? I cannot see the screen. 6, 6.
Dimethyl hept-3-ine.
Dimethyl hept-3-ine, right? Can you see this now?
Yes, sir.
It is the same structure, right? Even though it is looking a bit different, but I hope you can.
Almost same, sir.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it is just the way they have written this is a bit different, but it is the same molecule. There are two methyls here, right? So this is 6, 6 dimethyl hept-3-ine. And the other thing that some people will tell you will be, just let me just clear this drawing. They can also say that this particular element can be, it will be 2, 2 dimethyl and 1, 2, 3, 4 heptine. 2, 2. Now, can you see that it is 3 heptine and not hept-3-ine? Can you see that? Yes or no?
Yes,
can you see that?
Yes,
it is 3 heptine and it is not hept-3. So both of these are correct. But we are following only one rule. Okay, that we will number. I mean, jahan pe jo cheez hai, wahin pe number karein. This is also fine. But we will follow only one rule. Okay. So don't get confused. Whenever if somebody comes and sees that, see, this is the right. You say, achha, theek hai. Ho sakta ye bhi sahi ho, but we are following this nomenclature. Okay. We are following these rules only. So 2, 2 dimethyl and you can have 1, 2, 3, 4. To see 4 heptine. So yeah. 3. These are the, this is one of the pictures that I'm getting. This is 3 heptine, right? No, the heptine is there. No. there is no such 4,4,2-heptyne. No, there is no such substitution. This is only correct. I mean, there is no other way that you have to write this. So most of the chemistry websites, they are saying that this is the right name, that is 6,6-dimethylheptene. Okay. Anyone else in any other question? Please tell me. Yes, guys. Did you discuss all of them, or you discussed only few with each other?
Only like three.
Just a few.
So just few only. Okay, so tell me for this structure now, what is the name?
Sir,
Hamza, Hamza. The 5.54.
Okay, sir. 5,5,6,6 tetramethyl heptane 2-ol.
Yeah, correct, exactly. Very good. So 1, 2. Yeah, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4 like this. 7, right? So this will be 2-ol, right, at the end, and this is will be hept, and there will be 5,5,6,6, right? Tetra methyl. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so where did we end the last time?
Structured isomers.
Yeah.
Structural isomers. Okay.
Chain and skeleton isomers.
Oh, yeah. After that, we did chain and skeleton.
Chain. Okay. So we are done with chain and skeletal isomers, right? So next, you can also have. Let me give you some examples. Write the name for this molecule and write the name for this molecule. Yes, let me know if you're done. Okay. Done? Hamza, Hiba?
No, sir, doing it.
अच्छा ऐसे बताइए ना, ऐसे बताइए, कोई सब्स्टिट्यूएंट दिख रहा है आपको यहाँ पे?
नो सर,
नहीं दिख रहा है ना. तो यहाँ पे क्या होगा, सिर्फ पेरेंट होगा और देयर इज आई मीन डबल बॉन्ड ट्रिपल बॉन्ड भी नहीं है, तो एन होगा, है ना?
यस सर.
सो व्हाट इज द पेरेंट इन बोथ ऑफ देम?
फंक्शनल ग्रुप.
हाँ, पेरेंट एंड फंक्शनल. सो व्हाट इज द पेरेंट हियर, द फर्स्ट वन?
सर, आइसोप्रोपाइल.
हाँ, आइसोप्रोपाइल. आइसोप्रोपाइल कभी भी होगा, सब्स्टिट्यूएंट होगा. व्हाट इज द पेरेंट?
ओ या, ओके.
How many carbons? Three carbons, right? Bond देख के आप लोग नाम बता देते हैं, दो बॉन्ड देख के आप लोग ये तो बोलते रहे, नहीं, prop है ना, prop, N, 2-ol, yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Propane 2-ol, and this will be propane 1-ol, correct?
Yes, sir.
But this is also what, this has also have CH3, and there is CH here. So there is how many carbons? We have C3 and how many hydrogens? H8 hota na. So H ab yahan pe ho jayega C3H7 and OH. Yes or no? This is C3H7OH. Because here there is CH3. This is also CH3 and there is a hydrogen here.
Sir.
Okay. So what about this one? This is CH3. This has two hydrogen here. This also has two hydrogen here. So this is also C3H7OH. राइट
यस सर
राइट सो व्हाट इज चेंजिंग हियर व्हाट इज चेंजिंग एवरीथिंग इज सेम दिस इज प्रॉप दिस इज आल्सो प्रोपेन व्हाट इज चेंजिंग
द पोजीशन ऑफ फंक्शनल ग्रुप
वेरी गुड एंड दिस इज पोजीशन आइसोमेरिज्म ओके so the only point that you have to write here is what changes everything is same what is same molecular formula is same okay molecular formula is same molecular formula is same but the position of functional group or carbon multiple bond or substituent is different okay so we have looked at the example of functional group now we will also look at the example where there is a change in between carbon multiple bond and there is a change in the position of the substituent which is in the main chain so please write this down let me know if you're done अच्छा विच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन इन योर स्कूल कैन यू ऑल राइट इन द चैट प्लीज विच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन इन योर स्कूल यस हमजा प्लीज राइट इन द चैट विच चैप्टर इज गोइंग ऑन इन योर स्कूल राइट नाउ
यस सर चेकिंग दैट
अच्छा आपको याद भी नहीं है यू सेड रिवीजन इज गोइंग ऑन
यस सर बट बिफोर दैट चैप्टर वाज गोइंग ऑन सो दैट आई एम फाइंडिंग दैट
अच्छा फाइंड इट हिबा आपको भी नहीं याद है हिबा सो ओके सेम फॉर खालिद एंड सलमान ओके आई मीन एनी वन ऑफ यू कैन आंसर मी बिकॉज आई नो दैट यू बोथ आर स्टूडेंट ऑफ Ibn al-Haytham.
Like lastly, we had exams and I don't remember what happened after, before that.
Achha, what about Khalid? So, Hamza, is states of matter done? Le. Hamza is seeing some different chapter and Hiba is seeing some different chapter.
Sir, like our school is same, but the teachers and buildings are so far away. Like, teachers are different and buildings are so much far away. So,
अरे यार लेकिन
सर वी एंडेड ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री बिफोर द एग्जाम वी वर डूइंग रिवीजन ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री आफ्टर दैट वी एग्जाम स्टार्टेड
टर्म 2 हैज नॉट स्टार्टेड येट राइट
या नो सर फ्रॉम टुमारो
वी जस्ट फिनिश्ड पी ब्लॉक एंड लाइक हाइड्रोकार्बन स्टार्टेड जस्ट अ बिट आफ्टर दैट
हाइड्रोकार्बन अच्छा आई थिंक हाइड्रोकार्बन इज द ओके हाइड्रोकार्बन इज गोइंग ऑन ओके
They're like here, girls and boys are totally different campuses.
No, everywhere girls and boys are different.
Like, I mean, in India, it's together, right?
They're same. The syllabus, you mean?
Not syllabus, like classes.
Classes?
Yeah.
I don't think so. I teach your, seniors.
Seniors also?
I teach. They are not different. I teach your seniors.
Well,
like you don't know?
Exams also quite finished recently.
Achha.
So they're stuck in the same.
I don't know, maybe. I don't know that. But I teach your seniors. There are girls and boys both. And They have same syllabus only. They have, I mean, examinations also it is happening and like right now they are having.
Examinations, everything will happen same time. They have to finish the portion at the same time. But like in the middle, if you check, they'll be in different chapters.
Different chapters. Okay. So, I mean, it depends on the teacher, like what they are teaching and at what time. Okay, fine. Now, so position isomer, you guys wrote it, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So let us have some more example. For example, if you have C4H8, and this is what? This is alkene. This can have two formulas. One of these formula will be, you can have the double bond at the end of the carbon chain, or you can also have the double bond here. So both of these are what? Both of these are isomer. They are position isomer because the molecular formula is same for both of them. Similarly, you can also have what? C4H6. Now in C4H6, what will happen? You have CH3, then you have CH2, and after that you have C, which has a triple bond with CH. This is one of the formula for C4H6. You can count the hydrogens, or you can also write this as, there's also one possible formula, which is CH3 with what do we have here? Yeah, CH3, and then we will have C, triple bond C, and then you will have CH3. Yeah, right. So these are the two structures. So if you will name these two, now, if you will name these two, let me just get this guy and get it down here somewhere and write the names for these two. So this will be but1-ene, and this will be but2-ene. This will be but1-ine, and this will be but2-ine. Let me know if you're done.
Done, sir.
All of you? So let me just bit down. Now, for example, you can have, let me write the structure first. So this is pentane, and you have one carbon atom, one methyl group here, okay? One methyl group. So this has CH3, this will be CH, this will be CH2, CH3. So this has carbon harmony, this has five carbon, I can see that. There are six carbons, sorry. There are six carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 here. And hydrogens are 3, 3, 3, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Okay, C6H14. So for C6H14, you can have this structure, right? You can have this structure this will be in chain isomerism. Sorry. This will be skeletal isomerism that we have already done. Okay. In substituent, we will see in substituent. Substituent, for example, you have, you can have chlorine here, right? Or you can also have chlorine here, right? And somebody will say, so tell me, these two are same structures, right? These two are same structures, na? These two?
Yes, sir.
Anna? Yes, sir. I hope, yeah. Because already you can see that they are attached, this chlorine is attached where? This chlorine is attached on the equivalent carbon. Right? These two are equivalent carbons, right? And if any substituent is attached on the equivalent carbon, then they will be same only. So you can write this as an example. Also, for example, you can write in aromatic compounds, Cl and Cl. Cl, Cl. And at last, you have the para isomer. Okay, so the names are here are important. So see, if you have, let us first of all consider the atom number one. So this is the atom number one, okay? It's the atom number one. Now, if the second atom, is what? Just after the first atom, this position is known as ortho. Okay, this position is known as ortho. Okay, please remember that not this position is known as ortho, this position is not ortho. The position which is just adjacent to the first carbon atom that you have chosen, it is ortho. So for example, this and this here, they both are ortho, right? So this is what, this is known as ortho difluoro. Benzene, ortho dichlorobenzene. This position is known as meta. Okay, the second carbon. This is a meta dichlorobenzene. This is known as para. So it'll be para dichlorobenzene. So now we will do some examples on ortho, meta, and para. I will give you some examples. You have to tell me whether they are ortho substituted, para substituted, or meta substituted. है ना? इनको लिखिए.
So can you explain again, like the difference between meta and ortho? I know it's visually possible to see it, but again, once again.
The substituent is next to each other, right? Or you can say on adjacent, or you can say on adjacent carbons. In meta, you will have, so the substituents are separated by one carbon atom, right? There is one carbon atom which is between these two substituents. Substituents are visually, okay, only visually are separated. Are separated. ऐसे नहीं कि उन लोगों को अलग ही कर दे रहे हैं बिल्कुल chemically नहीं visually separated by one carbon atom and in para and obviously see only in benzenes, okay, only in benzene substituents are separated by two carbons. Now it is easy to identify.
Yes sir.
Now okay
sir, like can you hear me clearly if I talk this much?
Yeah, I can hear you. Sometimes it is there, but utna sabke liye hota hai. I mean, yours is not, what I can say, exceptionally bad. It's like usual only.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Let me know if you're done, guys.
Done, sir.
Done, sir.
Okay. Identify the following as ortho substituted, ortho meta or para substituted. Write the questions first, okay?
when you are writing the question, please think about it also. Okay.
Sir, the answer should be sent in chat or.
No, just keep the answers with you, okay? I will ask.
Okay.
Done, guys? Yes, Salman. Hamza, you are done, I guess.
Yes, sir, done.
So, tell me for the first one.
Ortho.
Ortho.
Second one. Okay. One more thing. You can also write O dichloro, O dibromo. Okay. So, you can write like this. O dibromo for the first one. Benzene. Hana? O dibromo benzene. Okay. Bibromo lithium. Dibromo. What about the second one?
So, para.
Very good. Third one?
Ortho.
Ortho.
Ortho. Fourth one?
Ortho.
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 Ortho. Fifth one?
Meta.
Meta. Meta. And meta. This one? Sixth one?
Meta.
Meta. Very good. Hai na? Asaan tha?
Yes. Ji, sir.
Now, write functional group isomerism. Hai na? But before functional group isomerism, let us say, for example, you have C2H6O. Okay. Now we can write this in two different ways. We can also write this like this, like CH3, CH2, OH, right? And we can also write it like this, CH3O, CH3. So both of them have the same molecular formula. That is what? Both of them have the same molecular formula. That is C2H6O. This is also C2H6 and O. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, this particular isomerism is arising due to these functional groups, right? This functional group is what? Achha, I have not given you some examples of this type of nomenclature, na?
No.
Today I will give you, okay? Today I will give you. I will do some at the end of the class and then we will give you some questions. Also, I have not given, I guess, for esters also. This type of molecules, right? No, na? Are boliye, 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 jaldi boliye. Nahi yaad aap logo ko kitna kya.
No, sir, you have not given.
No, you didn't. Mm-hmm.
Also for sulfonic acid also you didn't give.
Sulfonic acid nahi aane wala aap logo ka. Sulfonic acid nahi aane wala. What? First time exam hua aap logo ka?
Yeah.
Sir, from tomorrow, like starting from tomorrow.
Achha, kal se start ho raha. Achha, Salman, most of the, achha, did you get any question from IUPAC nomenclature in the examination?
No, like naming didn't come. Like it's most of them were, like MCQ.
Simple.
All of them were MCQs.
Haan, MCQs were there, but to usme IUPAC unhone naming nahi pucha.
No, that part didn't come.
Achha, not even a single question. Okay, that's strange. I mean, they should have at least give one question from IUPAC nomenclature.
I think it wasn't there.
It wasn't there in their syllabus. Achha.
Yeah, the naming.
So this is.
They didn't give the.
Achha. So this is alcohol. And this is ether. This is ether. So alcohol and ethers, they show functional group isomerism. Okay, they show functional group isomerism. Now, there can be some other things also that can show the functional group isomerism. For example, let us say that if you have C3H6 and one oxygen here, one oxygen. So this can be CH3, then CH2, and then one again carbon, and we can give one hydrogen here. And we have only one oxygen. So obviously this will be having a double bond here, right? Yes or no? Can you guys see this?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes,
so, and
sir.
This is
yes,
how many carbons? Three carbons. So this is CH3. You can also write it like this. CH3. this way, and there is a double bond carbon here. Correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this is aldehyde. And this is what? This is ketone. Correct? This is ketones. So aldehyde and ketones, they also show functional group isomerism. Functional group isomerism. So please write the topic, functional group isomerism. So there are a few more, okay? There are a few more. We will write all of them. Functional group. Isomerism. Okay, functional group isomerism. So what is different here?
Sir, functional group.
Yeah, functional group is different. No? Functional group is different. So see the names, if they will ask something, na? Agar aapse pucha jaye ki position isomerism mein kya different hai? Position different hai. Functional group mein kya different hai? Functional group different hai. Structural isomerism mein kya different hai? Structure different hai. Chain mein kya different hai? Chain different hai. So if you want to define it, you don't have to remember the definitions. Naam bola, usi se aapne bata diya ki kya yahan pe different hone wala hai. And what will be the same in all the cases? Molecular formula will be same in all of the cases. Okay, molecular formula will be same in all of the cases. And what is being different? It will change. So functional group, molecular formula is same. Molecular formula is same, but functional group is different. But functional group is different. So part A, you will write alcohols and ethers. Alcohols and ethers. Okay. They will show what? They will show the functional group isomerism. Now you can write the example I will give you. So there are three carbons and there is one OH. So this is OH bond, not the carbon. So black one I am representing as carbons. Okay. And then you have, let's write this as OH. CH2OH may be ho sakta tha na. This also has the formula that is C2H6O. This is also C2H6O. So see, the name for this will be what? This will be ethanol or ethane 1-ol. But the name for this will be, see, first of all, you have to choose a chain. You can choose any chain because both of them are same. So let us see that we have chose this one. So this is meth. And this is the substituent, this is methoxy, and this chain is methane. Let me just write it, all the things that you expect me to write. So what I am choosing here, I can choose one or any of the two branches that are going away from the oxygen atom, because both of them have only one carbon atom. Okay, only one carbon atom. So we are looking at here, okay? And this is our main chain, and this main chain does not have any functional group. So E. Then we will look at the unsaturation. There is no unsaturation. That is why AN. And this, our main chain has only one carbon. That is why this is meth. And this is our substituent. So this substituent is what? This is O. That is means oxy. And this is meth. So this will be methoxy. Okay. So this is the name methoxymethane. The name will be methoxymethane. Write this down. I will give you one more example, and from there also we can write the name, and that will help you. OH. So this is what? This is ethane 1-ol, and this is 1, 2, 3. This is propane 1-ol. Now the isomer for propane 1-ol will have like this structure, two carbon, and this is the third carbon, that is CH3. This is also CH3. So here you are having 1, two, three carbons. There are three carbons, and there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 8, H8, and O. This will be also C3H8O. Now, there are two branches going away from oxygen, which this has only two carbon atoms, and this has only one carbon atom. Okay. But even before that, let us write the is there any subfunctional group? No. Is there any unsaturation? No. AN. Now you have to choose which of them is longest, A or B. Which of them is longest?
A.
A is longest, right? So this will be eth. And then you have the substituent. So B will become the substituent here, okay? So this is your substituent. This is again methoxy. This is methoxy ethane. This is methoxy ethane. Write this down. Let me know if you're done. Done, guys.
So last one, I think the last one.
Okay.
Done, sir.
Okay. What about others? Done?
Yes, sir.
Right, B. Aldehydes and ketones. Okay. So aldehydes and ketones, we can write like this. There are three carbons. This is aldehyde, and then you can also have, so this is also C3H6O. This is also C3H6O. C, you can write carboxylic acids. And esters. So I'm not writing the names for which you can write the names, okay? For example, aldehyde and ketones, I hope you can write the names. Carboxylic acids and esters. So let us look at a carboxylic acid. The second to simplest one, that is ethanoic acid. This will be CH3. So it'll be carbon with a double bond oxygen and a, and then you will have what? An OH group, right? An OH group. This is a carboxylic acid, this is ethanoic acid. Ethanoic, or you can also write ethane 1-oic acid, ethanoic acid. Okay, ethanoic acid. For ester, you can have what? For ester, you have a carbon like this with a double bond oxygen with a hydrogen here, and then you have oxygen and OCS3. Okay, C double bond O, OCS3. How will I write the name for this? So this is divided into two fragments, and always you would write it like this. This is OCS3. Okay. So I'm sorry, my mom was here. She was asking me whether I want to eat something because I had not done dinner. Okay, so this is ethanoic acid. So ester is like this, OCS3. So what you will do, you will always bifurcate. Please listen, okay? You will always bifurcate this bond. But also remember, you have to write what? O8 first, right? The functional group is O8. So as soon as you have recognized that this is an O8, okay? This will be an O8, right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
याद है ना सबको?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
So as, as soon as you have written O8, okay? Now, when you have written O8, and after that, you will see, is there any double carbon-carbon double bond? No, carbon-carbon double bond is not there. Then you will write AN, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Now, as you can see, this is the carbon which is having the functional group. And this is the only carbon which is having functional group. That is why this will be meth. Right? And what is this substituent? This will be the substituent now because we have considered all of these parts, right? We have considered this part because this is the group ester. And what is remaining? Only methyl. One, which is a sub. Yeah, methyl. Very good. So this will be methyl methanoate. This will be methyl methanoate. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Please write this down. Let me know if you're done. Are you done? Done? Not done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Done.
Acha. Write D. Dienes. Dienes means there will be two double bonds. Alenes. Alenes is a specific type of double bond that you can have. The double bonds are adjacent to each other, and alkynes. For example, you can have, this is buta 1,3-diene. Okay, this is but 1,3-diene, and you can also have something like this. Let me write it like this, okay? Because it cannot be a straight chain, but I can ignore that in CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. You can also have CH2 with a double bond carbon, with a double bond C, and H and CH3. You can also have CH3. CH2, C triple bond, CH. So there are carbon R4, here also carbon R4, also carbon is 4. How many hydrogens? 2, 4, 6. Here also 2, 3 and 3, 6. Here also 3 to 5 and 6. Okay, so all of these are having same thing. So this is diene. That means there are two double bonds. Now, this is a specific type of double bond, which is known as allene. Okay, because this one single carbon is having what? Two double bonds. Okay, only a single carbon is having two double bonds, which is known as allene. And this is what? This is alkyne, as you have already seen many times. This is alkyne. If you want the name, so this will be but 1,3-diene. And what will be this? This will be but 1,2-diene. And this will be but 1-iene. This will be but 1-iene.
Sir, the second one is also diene or allene?
It is a specific type of diene, which is commonly known as allene. Iske naam mein lekin diene hi rahega. Okay. Naam mein iske diene hi rahega. Mm-hmm.
Done, sir.
What about others? Done?
No, yes, sir, done.
Salman, you are writing?
Yeah, I will.
Yeah. I think isomers, even isomers is not very detailed in your NCERT, right?
Sir, it's deleted, teacher said, I think.
Huh? Teacher said it is deleted?
No idea, sir. Teacher said it, I guess, during revision.
Me too, I feel like that.
What about Hamza Heba? You guys were taught isomerism?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I think isomerism is not deleted. Isomerism is not deleted. Wait a second. Let me see. Deleted for 20. I mean, for 21. Now they don't. Organic chemistry. No, it is not deleted. So, only the. Sorry?
Teacher deleted lots of portions from that chapter.
By the
isomers, I think, was one of them, I think.
Teacher must have deleted the methods of purification, qualitative and quantitative analysis. जो थोड़ा सा लैब टाइप का पार्ट था ना
है ना वो तो
दैट इज तो श्योरली डिलीटेड आई मीन इट इज आल्सो इन द डिलीटेड पोर्शन दैट द सीबीएसई रिलीज्ड आल्सो बिकॉज़ 2020 एंड 2021 दे हैव द सेम सिलेबस एंड इन 2020 सीबीएसई रिलीज्ड द डिलीटेड पोर्शंस एंड इन दोस डिलीटेड पोर्शन वी हैड क्वालिटेटिव एंड क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस एंड वन मोर थिंग व्हाट डिड आई से मेथड्स ऑफ प्योरिफिकेशन या बट आइसोमर्स इज देयर ओके आइसोमर्स इज देयर आई मीन इट इज नॉट डिटेल्ड एज सच दैट उन्होंने सारे एग्जांपल्स दिए मैं बस एल्डिहाइड और कीटोन और शायद इसका एग्जांपल दिया है ईथर एंड अल्कोहल बट दीज आर आल्सो फंक्शनल ग्रुप आइसोमेरिज्म देन यू कैन राइट लास्ट वन दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट व्हिच इज ओके दिस इज व्हाट डीना ई नाउ प्राइमरी सेकेंडरी प्राइमरी secondary or tertiary or tertiary amines okay primary secondary or tertiary amines so for example if you have a molecule which is CH3 CH2 CH2 and then you have NH2 so this is known as propane this is known as propane 1 amine. This is known as what? Propane 1 amine. And what do we see? This nitrogen is bonded to how many carbon atoms? This nitrogen is bonded to how many carbon atoms? One carbon, right?
Yes, sir. One carbon.
This is known as 1-degree amine. Okay. This is known as 1-degree amine. That is why primary amine. Also, we can have, see, nitrogen has two hydrogens. Na? That means, it may be, hum lo na, jaise, jo chain isomer type ka cheez hota tha, we can do the same thing with nitrogen also. See, you can have CH3. We can have treating this now as carbon, जिसको हम shift कर सकते हैं अलग-अलग जगहों पे. CH3, CH2, and then I will put nitrogen here. So this nitrogen will have only one hydrogen, and the next carbon will have CH3. Okay? Sometimes you will see this as nitrogen and H here, like this. So see the formula here is what the formula here is. C3H9, 3, और 4, 3 और 7 और 2 9 and N. Here also the formula is CH3 and hydrogen is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now, what will be the name of this type of molecule? So this type of molecule is what? See, this is a methyl group and this is ethane amine, correct? This is a methyl group and this is, if I name this much, this is ethane amine. So this is known as methyl, which will be the substituent. Then you have ethane amine. Okay, methyl ethane amine. Now, just to show that the nitrogen is attached with one more carbon atom, we write this N dash. Okay, so this is now 2-degree amine. Now, these are new nomenclature rules that you are learning. So just see this, don't need it for this year. Okay. There is one complete chapter on amine, the 12th standard. There you need it. But as of now, आप लोगों ने अगर ऐसा कहीं देखा तो आपको लगना चाहिए कि हाँ ऐसी देखा है हमने ऐसा होता है हमको आता नहीं है लेकिन हमको पता है है ना. सो यू शुड नो व्हाट यू डोंट नो. सो दिस इज समथिंग दैट यू विल नॉट नो दिस ईयर. एन मिथाइल इथेन एमीन. सो दिस एन इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग दैट अदर देन द मेन चेन कार्बन एटम्स, अदर देन द मेन चेन कार्बन एटम्स, द नाइट्रोजन इज ऑल्सो अटैच्ड टू वन मोर कार्बन. ओके, दैट इज टू डिग्री एमीन. Now there can be also one more in which this nitrogen, is attached to three different methyl groups. CH3 and CH3. Here also you can see that there are three carbons, there are nine hydrogens, and what? And you have only one nitrogen. So the formula is same, but the name becomes, so let me write it here, okay? N CH3 CH3 CH3. So we may choose any one, okay? We may choose this as the main chain. And the other will be the substituent. So we will write dimethyl. This is our main chain. And these are the substituent. Okay, these are the substituent. So we'll write dimethyl. Methane amine, and then we will write n comma n dash. So n comma n means other than the main chain carbon atom, nitrogen is also attached to two different carbon atom, two other carbon atoms also, and hence this is what, three degree amine. Done, guys.
I'm writing the last one.
Acha.
Done, sir.
Okay, is there anyone who is still writing? No. The last is metamerism. So this will be the fourth one. Metamerism. So see. The molecular formula is same. But you have different, number of carbon atoms are present on either sides. Different number of carbon atoms are present on either sides of functional group. This functional group is not from the list of functional group. Okay, so this is generic functional group. For example, this generic functional group, even chlorine can be also a functional group. Okay, but it is not in the list of functional group that we have written. So IUPAC normal classification ke liye jo functional group hum logon ne likha hai, that is different, and that is only for functional group. But if you have any atom which is other than carbon and hydrogen in organic chemistry, that is known as functional group. Okay, but for the case of IUPAC nomenclature, the functional group are those 10 that you have written in your notebook. That's it. Acha, metamerism mein kya kya aata hai? Metamerism mein, for example, if you have ether, okay, if you have ether, so let us say you have CH3, CH2O, CH3. राइट नाउ इसमें नहीं होगा, इसमें तो कुछ नहीं होगा. वेट अ सेकंड, यू कैन हैव ओनली इफ यू हैव 5 कार्बन्स. ओके सो दिस इज वन ऑफ देम. सो यू हैव कार्बन 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 5 carbons and how many hydrogens will be there? 12 hydrogens and oxygen, right? So you have C5H12 and O. Another way of writing this will be just to shift O from here to here. So this will be carbon now. And let us say not here. Let us change this to here. This is carbon, oxygen, then again carbon, then again. Okay, so now this has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 P5, let us look at the hydrogen. CH3, HNH, HNH, and CH3. So hydrogen are 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, 12. H12O. Okay. So this is known as metamerism. This is known as metamerism. Please remember that what is happening here. The position is not changing. Okay, don't say that position is changing. The name for this one will be the main. Let us write like this first. An E because there is no functional group. An because there is no carbon-carbon double bond. Then we have to choose the main chain. So this will be the main chain here. So this is what 1, 2, 3. That is prop. So this is prop, and then you have the substituent, which is. There are 2 carbons from here. 2 carbons means what? This will be eth and oxygen. That means it will be ethoxy. So ethoxy propane, and this ethoxy is on which carbon atom? So we'll start from here. 1, 2, 3. So on the first carbon atom only, that is why we can write, ethoxy propane, or we can also write 1-ethoxy propane. There's no difference between them. But for this carbon, we have the main chain here. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 carbon atoms. That is why this will be methoxy. Methoxy 1, 2, 3, 4. Butane. Methoxy butane. Okay, so the whole name is different. Nothing is same here. Okay, the numbers are not changing. Please see that numbers are not changing.
Sir, parent chain is changing, right?
No, even parent chain is also changing. Substituent is also changing. That is why we cannot say it is skeletal or chain isomer.
Yeah.
Sure. Done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. So similar type of isomerism can also be shown if you have nitrogen, which is secondary nitrogen. Okay. So let's just write B. And you have CH3, CH2, NH. You have CH2, CH3. So if I shift this nitrogen to here, you will get CH3, NH, CH2, CH2, CH3. Now for this, the main chain can be any one of them. First of all, let me write the functional group. The functional group is here amine. Here also the functional group is amine. There's no change till now. But as soon as we go to the main chain, the main chain here is 1, 2, that is eth. So this will be ethane. First of all, I will write ane, and then I will write eth. And ethane, I mean, these two are left now. So this will be ethyl. So ethyl, ethane, amine, ethyl, ethane, amine is there. And let me just get this a bit together. And we have to write N dash, right? Because this will represent that it is a secondary one. For this, the name will be propane, and this will be methyl. here also I have to put N dash because we have to show it as a secondary amine. Done.
Yes, sir.
The last one is stereoisomerism. This is the second part, okay? Structural isomerism are done. You have stereo. Isomerism. Stereoisomerism. Now here what happens, here you will have the compound which will have same molecular formula and same structural formula also, okay? Same molecular formula and same structural formula. But what will happen? But the position of atoms, now they will differ in space. Okay. Now, when I will give you the example, then only you will understand. But the relative positions of atoms or groups differ in they will differ in space. How will they differ in space? For example, see, you have carbon and carbon double bond. Okay, please see, don't write. If you're writing, please don't write. Carbon double bond. You have here a CH3 group, and here also you have a CH3 group like this. Okay, and then you have a hydrogen here, and then you have a hydrogen here. Now, look at the distance that you will have here. Okay, now what I will do, I will take this particular molecule and I will just copy paste it. But I will not do, I will change the position. Now, see, I am not changing exactly the position of this CH3. What I am just doing, writing hydrogen here and the carbon CH3 molecule here. Now, in this particular A structure, we had this carbon molecule which had CH3. Here also the same carbon molecule is having CH3. But what has changed from A to B? What has changed from A to B? And are these same or different? It's just the distance, right? Can you see the distance from here to here is this much? The distance from these two methyl group is this much, yes or no? The distance is larger here, right?
Yes, sir.
Now, see, the definition of isomerism is that if you have same molecular formula, okay, you will have same molecular formula, but there will be some difference in the chemical or physical properties. So what kind of property is changing here? What physical chemical property will be changing here? We will look at this. So if I take this first example here, so what I will do is, now I will show you these. Okay, so please write this down and let me just draw in. तो हमें चाहिए क्या चीज, हमें चाहिए draw tool. I need carbon. अच्छा, it's better if I do this. Okay, are you guys done writing? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So can you see this now?
Yes.
Or no? Okay. So this is a what? This is a carbon atom, right? Yes or no? Can you see that?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Anna, now this what I will do, I will make one more carbon atom here like this. Okay, now it has, it is now what? It is ethane now, yes or no? It is ethane, na? नहीं दिख रहा क्या आप लोगों को?
Yes sir, yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay. Now if I will click on the bond now, then it will become double bond. ठीक है? अब क्या हो गया? Ethene हो गया. Yes or no?
Yes sir, ethene.
Ethene हो गया, है ना? Now I will just rotate this a bit. I will just rotate this a bit like this, है ना? So that you can see it better. This is how you draw and copy, ना? ऐसे ही हम लोग लिखते हैं copy. Now what I will do? I will also draw one more carbon atom here. Correct? Okay. And one more carbon atom here. So this is the A structure that we have written. Yes or no? This is the
yes,
A structure,
sir.
Na? यही लिखा था हम लोगों ने. अच्छा बस अब इसमें क्या करना रहता है ना? I cannot leave it like this. I cannot leave it like this. हमने तो अपने हिसाब से यहाँ पे bond length बड़ा छोटा सब कुछ कर दिया. I have to optimize it. Okay? I have to optimize it. So there is one function here. Optimize geometry. So this is one time optimization has happened. This from if I do it from here. MMF4 is a force field that works good for this type of, and I will do for 100 steps. So not much. Okay, can you see that this bond is now very much small?
Yes, sir.
है ना? So ये, I mean, optimization में होता है. This is one of the most stable structure. Okay, this is one of the most stable structure. अच्छा, now what I will do? I will calculate the energy of this system. Okay, I will calculate the energy of the system extensions. Molecular mechanics and calculate. So what is the energy? Around 30 kilojoule per mole.
Yes, sir. 26.
So just write.
26.
Ah, yeah. Sorry. Yeah, yeah. Sorry. 26. So just write in your copy A 26 kilojoules per mole. Done.
Yes.
A
sir.
Is done. Okay. So now what I will have to do? I will make this as CH3 and then I have to delete this atom. So I will just select these atoms and I will delete it. But for this I have to add one hydrogen. Okay, valency to carbon ki kya rahegi?
Rotated carbon.
Sorry?
We could have just rotated the carbon only.
Nahin, nahin, nahin. Aise hota hi nahin. Agar carbon ko rotate karte to wo aata hi nahin. Structure is only different. That is why rotation will not work. Karke dikha de kya? This was the structure, na?
Yeah.
Ab bataiye.
No, just Amy select those three.
Huh?
Just select those three.
Okay. Now. Aap yaad kijiye chemical bonding ka wo din. Jab humne padhaya tha. So you want me to rotate these particular elements, I guess, right? These two, right? इसको ऐसे करके रोटेट कर दे, है ना? Now, does anyone want to say something? Can we do that, guy?
I think no, sir.
Why not? क्या होगा उससे?
Sir, the whole molecule will change.
अच्छा नहीं वो तो दूसरी नहीं अच्छा ठीक है change का अलग अलग बात है. In somewhere during chemical bonding, I said a word which is diamond pushups. Did I say
yes,
diamond
sir,
pushups?
Yes, sir.
Ab bataiye. What will happen? The double bond will break. If I will rotate
the double bond.
Hai na, Salman?
Oh, yeah.
Got it? So, double bond, the restriction of rotation. Humne bola tha organic chemistry mein kaam aane wala, hai na? Yehi pe kaam aane wala ki double bond mein rotate agar hum karenge, then what will happen? The double bond will break. Now, due to the restriction of the rotation of double bond, we get the isomers, okay? So, the reason why we are getting the isomers is that because the rotation cannot be happening. Now, if it is single bond, then the rotation obviously will be happening. But if it is a double bond, then the rotation of these molecules will not be happening. So what I have to do, I have to change the molecule. Okay, whenever you have to break bonds, that means it is a different structure. So the same thing that I will be doing here is, let me just select these and delete this. And I have to add hydrogen. So let me just add hydrogen here. And then I will just change this hydrogen to carbons, right? Now what I have to do, I have to optimize it. Now please, you will look at this bond, okay? Can you see my arrow?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so you just yes, look sir. At this bond. Okay, just look at this bond. Do you see?
Yes, sir. It increased.
Yes, sir.
increased hai na it increased so pehle kya tha na ch bond tha so obviously hydrogen is what hydrogen is very small 1s now hydrogen 1s will be smaller that is why the bond length was very small as you can see here also the bond length is very small here the bond length is larger right because the bonding here is due to the sp this is sp3 and sp2 hybrid orbitals which are bonding here that is why the bond length is larger here there is the sp2 and there is the 1s and 1s ki wajah se thoda kam hai yahan pe okay let me just clear all these drawings let me stop annotations and I think I am back to this screen now if I will calculate this energy okay let us calculate this energy what is the energy here 20.29 right
yes sir
so which is more stable a or b
sir a
अच्छा सो एनर्जी लेट अस सी एनर्जी इन टर्म्स ऑफ हीट ओके ठीक है हमजा
यस सर
सो अ बॉडी व्हिच इज हैविंग हायर एनर्जी इज हैविंग हायर टेम्परेचर ओके
यस सर
नाउ यू टेल मी आप किस स्टेट में ज्यादा स्टेबल होंगे हायर एनर्जी या लोअर एनर्जी हायर टेम्परेचर पे आप स्टेबल होंगे लोअर ना सो व्हिच इज मोर स्टेबल ए और बी
सर बी
B is more stable, right? Now we will look at what is the reason. What is the reason that B is more stable? So, hota ye hai na ki see. Acha, wait a second. Let me also na see what I have shown you na. This thing is not the real structure. Aise bond hote nahi. The structure which is more the closest to reality is the this one. कुछ समझ में आ रहा है इसमें
नो सर
नहीं ना बट कैन यू सी द ओवरलैपिंग्स कैन यू सी द ओवरलैपिंग्स
कैन यू सी समवट
है ना समवट इट इज रिकॉग्नाइजेबल राइट सो सी यहां पे दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर लाइक दिस नाउ लेट मी जस्ट चेंज दिस टू बॉल एंड स्टिक एंड लेट मी जस्ट डू सम अच्छा अब इसमें देखते हैं जो रियल स्ट्रक्चर होता है वो कैसा होता इट वुड बी लाइक दिस Can you see that there will be a very high rate of repulsion here? See these two CH3 molecules. Okay, this is also CH3. This is also CH3. And यहाँ पे आपके पास ये double bond है, ठीक है? So these CH3 molecules ना, how close they are? Can you see that how close they are? They will be repelling each other. And repulsion, if there is repulsion, what happens? Energy increases. That is why this is having approximately 30. And if you have something like this, this is having some approximately 21 kilojoule per mole. So this is the reason for the difference in energy that they are very near to each other, the large CH3 molecules, and hence there is higher repulsion, which leads to higher energy and less stability. Okay, so this guy here is this will be repelling each other. Okay, but if you have these two. They won't be repelling each other because they are far apart. Okay, so here there will be repulsion. Okay, and this type of bonding, now this type of bonding is known as cis. This is what? This is we say that this is cis but 2-ene, and this will be trans but 2-ene. अगर हम यहां से यहां तक देखें तो देखिए सब कुछ सेम ही है एंड दिस इज द पार्ट वेयर स्टीरियोआइसोमेरिज्म कम्स सिस एंड ट्रांस ओके सो द डबल बॉन्ड इन डबल बॉन्ड यू हैव ओनली टू कैटेगरीज वेदर इट विल बी सिस और वेदर इट विल बी ट्रांस ओके गाइस
यस ओके
दिस इज वी विल राइट दिस टाइप ऑफ आइसोमेरिज्म ना इज आल्सो नोन एज ज्योमेट्रिकल आइसोमेरिज्म Why? Because in geometrical isomerism, what happens? The distance is the only difference is of distance, and distance is part of geometry. That is why it is known as geometrical isomerism. Let me know if you are done.
Done, sir.
All of you are done.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Done.
So write a note. Cis isomers are less stable than trans isomers. Due to high steric repulsion. Due to high steric repulsion. Okay, see, if you want to play with structures now, so the software that I use, the software that you just saw, it is known as Avogadro. So if sometimes you're free and you just want to visualize various structures, the chemical structures, then you can do that in Avogadro. It is Avogadro. Then guys?
Yes, sir. Then.
What about others? Salman, Khalid. Yes, Salman, Khalid, done. अरे क्या हो गया सलमान खालिद नॉट डन और आर यू डन
डन
अच्छा नाउ कम्स द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट इज फंडामेंटल कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री रिएक्शन मैकेनिज्म एंड दीज कॉन्सेप्ट्स वी विल स्टार्ट दिस इज अ कंप्लीटली न्यू टॉपिक चेंज द पेज ओके चेंज द पेज अब जो पीछे आपने आई पैक अमर किचर वगैरह पढ़ा दैट विल ओनली बी यूजफुल फॉर नेमिंग द मॉलिक्यूल्स द कॉन्सेप्ट दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम टुडे दे विल नॉट बी हेल्पिंग यू I mean, those normal teachers will not be helping you here, okay? So these are very new concepts. So you can change the page also if you want. And you will write organic reaction mechanism, ORM. Organic reaction mechanism. Organic reaction mechanism. Okay, what is this? This is known as ORM. Okay. Now, in reaction mechanism, what is reaction mechanism? See, reaction mechanism, what do? We give some detailed stepwise description of a particular reaction. Ki kaise kaise kya kya ho raha hai, na? How everything is happening. And why do we need reaction mechanism? Why do we need reaction mechanism? So see, there are two main school of thoughts in science. Some say that science is used to explain things. Some say that science is used to predict things. Okay, science is used to predict things. So, I mean, there is a difference of opinion what is science used for mainly, whether it is used to predict something or it is used to explain something. I mean, there are various arguments supporting both of these cases, that is explanation and prediction. But here what we will do is we explain a few things. By that explanation, we predict a few things. Okay, we directly don't predict anything. What do? We explain how things are happening. Then when we see a pattern by this explanation, we see some pattern. Then from that pattern, what do? From that pattern, we recognize a pattern and then we predict a few other things. Okay. Now, what is this explanation, prediction, and pattern is doing in organic reaction mechanism. In organic reaction mechanism, if you are explaining a few things and you have seen a pattern, so what you will be learning about now is patterns in reactions. Okay, we will be learning about patterns in reactions. So there are some patterns that chemists have already saw, that chemists have already saw. And now what we are going to learn, we are going to learn the pattern of those. We are going to just learn the pattern. And after this, when we are given reactants, we will apply these patterns to reactant and we will predict the products. Okay, we will predict the products. So these patterns, they have come from explanations, and those explanations gave you pattern, and we will apply those pattern to the reactants, and then we'll predict the products. Then we will predict the products. So this is the idea of organic reaction mechanism. Okay, this is the idea of organic reaction mechanism. So let us start with a simple thing, which is the reaction. How does reaction happens? Reaction has reactants. Please see first reactants, and these reactants will give you product. Okay, these reactants will give you product. Don't write anything now. Please listen. We'll give you some product. Now, in the arrow, you can write what? You can also write some conditions. Okay, for example, if you want, jaise chai agar aapko banani hai na, to chai mein bhi aapka reaction hi ho raha hai, kuch na kuch to, because you have also heated it. And preparation of tea is a chemical change, because you cannot revert it back to sugar, milk and water, etc. Right? So it is not a physical change, it is a chemical change. You cannot change it. You cannot change it, okay, directly. I mean, physically you cannot change it, whatever you have done with the tea. So there are some conditions for making tea. That is, first of all, is you should have some heat. Okay, you should have some heat. Similarly, in reactions also, we'll give some kind of conditions while we are doing that reaction. And those conditions are written on the arrow above or below. Okay, so conditions. Now, this condition is not majorly for you. You will be majorly considering the reactants and the products. Okay, reactants and the product. Now, in reactant, there are two things. In reactants, there are two things in organic chemistry. There is an organic molecule, which we call as substrate. And there is an attacking reagent. There's an attacking reagent, which we generally call just as reagent. Okay, so there is substrate and there is a reagent. The substrate is generally organic molecule. This is generally organic molecule. Okay, and this reagent can be either organic or inorganic. I mean, it depends. It really depends what is, I mean, it's not sure. It can be anything. Okay. It can be anything, organic or inorganic. So now what we are going to do, we are going to study substrates, the attacking reagent, and what happens when the substrate attacks, when the attacking reagent attacks the substrate, we get an intermediate between the reactants and product. So we get an intermediate. And after that, we get a product. Okay, so if you are getting some intermediate, you have to study intermediates also, and then we will form the product. Okay, so please write this now. Reactant, there are some conditions, that is temperature, pressure, or solvent also sometimes. Product, reactants are of two types, substrate or attacking reagent, then you have product. All of you are done.
Wait, sir, last one.
Okay. You can see Hiba is done. Done?
Done, sir.
Okay. So what is a reaction mechanism or organic reaction mechanism? So there is a big definition that you can see in NCERT, but what we will be focusing on will be study of, or rather it will be a detailed study of, detailed study of the stepwise description of reaction. Okay, detailed study of stepwise description, stepwise description of a reaction. Electron movement, this is very important. Electron movement, right? Now, electron will be moving while the bonds are breaking and forming. Electron movement during bond breaking and formation. Bond breaking and formation. Okay, so this is what organic reaction mechanism for us, hai na? And the most important part here is electron movement. The most important part is electron movement. In this, first we will learn about the bond breaking. Okay, first we will learn about the bond breaking. That is more, what I can say, predictable. That is more predictable. Okay, so first we will learn about the bond breaking. Are you done, guys? Done. Yep. Okay. So see, there can be, if you have a molecule which is AB. Okay, A has a bond with B. Please look here. A has a bond with B. And there can be two ways in which the bond can break. There can be two ways in which the bond can break. We all know that this bond is what? It is composed of two electrons, right? It's composed of two electrons like this. Now, what can happen in a way is that you have AB. Now, both these electrons are taken by B. Okay, both these electrons are taken by B, or it can be the other thing also. But what we can say is both the electron in the bond pair is taken by one of the atoms. It is taken by one of the atoms, okay? And what else can happen is you have two electrons here. Now, one of the electron is taken by one atom and the other electron is taken by the another atom. So this is the only way by which you can break the bond. If you break bonds like this, you will have A. Now, this A had, initially it had electrons with it, a bond, but it does not have those electrons. And obviously it has lost its electrons because this is a covalent bond. Now, okay, let me just write it like this. This is a blue bond. So it's a blue electron. So this blue electron belongs to A. This blue electron belongs to the A valence shell. Pure atomic A valence shell has this blue electron. Now this blue electron is also taken by the B. That is why what will happen? A will get a positive charge. Plus, this B will get those two electrons. This is the blue electron from the atom of A. And this. Now what has happened? It has got one extra electron. That is why it will get a negative charge. It will get a negative charge. Now what will happen in this case? A will have a free radical, we say it free radical, but it will be neutral. And B will also get one electron. And we say that these are radicals and these are neutral. Okay, these are neutral. So this will be a cation. There will be an anion here. Please don't write anything. I hope you are not writing. And here also what? This will be a free radical. This will be a free radical. And this will also be a free radical. Okay, so as you can see, these are the two ways in which you can break a bond. Now, the first way is known as heterolytic cleavage. Okay, so you are breaking the bond, heterolytic cleavage, or it is also known as heterolytic fission. Okay, fission means breaking. And then if you have the second type, this is known as homolytic. Cleavage or homolytic fission. Okay, so there are two types. Now in homolytic cleavage, what happens? We form free radicals like this. And also see that what I have done, when I had to move the electrons, so I started from the electron source, that is where the electrons are present, and I moved the arrow to the atom which has the electron, to the atom which has received the electron. And I have used two-headed arrow, and here I have used a single-headed arrow, or we should say that this is a fish hook arrow. Okay, so let me write a few things here also. So this particular arrow, how should I write this? If you have two-headed arrow, this is known as what? This is known as double-headed arrow, or a complete arrow you can see, okay? Or a complete arrow you can see. So please write this now. You can write this now. एरो के बारे में भी आपको बता देंगे, अच्छे से आप लोग लिख लीजिए एरो के बारे में, बिकॉज इट इज ऑल्सो इम्पोर्टेंट. हाउ इज द वेदर देयर? सऊदी वाले पहले बताएं.
सर कोल्ड, लाइक इट इज ड्रॉपिंग बाय 20 डिग्री नाउ.
अच्छा, इट इज ऑलमोस्ट 20 डिग्री नाउ.
ओके यस.
अब बहरीन वाले बताएं.
It just rained today. It's normal. Sorry, it just rained today. First, ha, I, in Bahrain it rains a lot. No, it just rained today. Okay, it just rained today. Here in masjid, so like the imams are praying for rains, but there is no rain, no sign of rain anywhere.
अच्छा, सो इज इट अ आई मीन वेदर फॉर रेन नाउ देयर? यूजुअली रेन्स देयर?
नो, लाइक नॉट यूजुअली, बट मोस्टली लाइक इन विंटर एटलीस्ट वन टाइम इट रेन्स हियर.
ओके,
लाइक अराउंड अ वीक इट विल बी फुल ऑफ रेन.
अच्छा, अ वीक विल बी फुल ऑफ रेन. आई मीन व्हेन द वेदर स्विचेस फ्रॉम हॉट टू कोल्ड, इट रेन्स.
या.
And one question for you guys. What do you think? The kingdom, na? Was the kingdom always a desert? Or do you think it was very green and it had many forest at one point of time?
A desert. Like if we look through hadith and all, it was desert.
No. Before that, what do you think?
So it was all desert, yeah.
All desert?
Mountain and deserts.
Mountains and desert. Okay. Does anyone have any other thing to say? It was always a desert.
Possibilities.
The possibilities. But there is something, I mean, which is the elephant in the room, like in the kingdom. Can you tell me the economy of kingdom is based on what?
Sir, fuel.
Okay. What fuel?
Petroleum.
Fossil fuel.
Fossil fuel. What is a fossil?
Oh yeah, according to what you are saying, yeah, it's possibilities.
Are you getting a hint, Hamza? Are you getting the hint?
No, sir, no.
Fossil fuel. Okay, how fossil fuel forms? Do you know that?
Yes, sir. Like it will be buried under the ocean and all like that.
Yeah. So you have anything which contains carbon. Okay. For example, what contains carbon for the most of the time? Humans, we also contain carbon, but plants, trees, okay? So they contain carbon.
Sir, correct? Like, there were forests here, but not very, like, not vast forests.
Not like every, I mean,
Nay, nay, nay. If you will see, I mean, you know how rich it's in oil, right?
Yes, sir.
So it would have had plenty of forest at one point of time. I mean, then only it is possible that it would have so much of fossil fuel there. Right. So not in the recent years, like we can say that all, I mean.
So even now, like maybe, in just in cities, there are trees outside the city. It is all deserted there.
Yeah, yeah, I know that. So maybe I think, I don't know, maybe around a million years ago, there would be complete forest and all. I'm talking about that timeline, not 1,000 years and 2,000 years. I'm talking about
10 years ago. Then it was whether it is possible. Yeah.
Yeah, it is. And while you were saying, according to hadith, there is a hadith also that this kingdom, I mean, this area was very green and lavish.
Before. No, like Prophet said to, Anas or Ibn Abbas, he said that if you live long, planting areas in Tabuk, it will be green it will be very rich in greenery.
It was once green and it will again become green.
Yes, sir.
So now what you are talking about is the latter part of the hadith. So yeah, and also, I mean, speaking in that way that fossil fuels are there, then obviously it would have been green, then only you have so much of fossil fuel there. Okay. Now I will write to write about the arrows. So you have this arrow, right? Okay. So this part is known as the head. This is the head of the arrow.
And rest of them are tail.
this is the tail. This is the tail, okay? This is the tail of the arrow. Okay, this is the head and this is the tail. This tail, tail will be on electron rich source, okay, electron rich. So what are the electron rich? So you will have, I mean, whether it will be originating from bonds or it will be originating from bonds or it will be originating from lone pair, or if you have negative charge, which is another, I mean, same thing as lone pair, only negative charge. Or this head, it will be reaching what electron sink. You say electron poor. So most of the, I mean, it will be always reaching atoms only. Okay, it will be reaching atoms. Okay, it will be always reaching atoms. Okay, it will be always reaching atoms. So please write this. Sometimes you will see that I am directly doing it with the bonds. For example, I will sometimes write like this. For example, you have, I will completely shift the bond from bond, but again you can see that double bond is there, so more electron are here, and this is a single bond, less electron are there. So obviously from double bond to single bond we can do that, but I can never do it like this. Okay, I can never do that like this. It will be wrong. This is wrong. Okay, so generally atoms, and it happens like this. X, so it goes here first and then it becomes like this, then it goes then here, then it becomes like this. Okay, so if I just skip this part, if I just skip this part and I directly go from here to here, this is the end product that we see. So we directly write it like this. Okay, we can directly write it like this, but essentially it happens via atom. It happens via atom. Okay, bond se bond transfer nahi hota hai. Done? Are you done with this one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what I will do, I will give you some example for heterolytic cleavage. Okay, for heterolytic cleavage and how to predict where the electron will be going. Okay, where the electron will be going. So, if you have A and B, and B will be taking the arrow only if, let us say, B is more electronegative. Then you will switch it like this. Okay. That means B will be taking more and more electrons. B will be taking more and more electrons. Got it? Yes or no? B will be getting more and more electrons. Okay. So for example, if you have, let us say CH3, Cl, then what do you think? Then what will happen? You will form A positive plus B negative. Now you will tell me. So I will start, the arrow from where? The single bond, the carbon atom or the chlorine atom? Where should I start the, arrow from? The tail should be at single bond. And the head will be on?
A chlorine.
Chlorine atom, right? Because it is more electronegative. So you will get CH3 positive plus Cl negative. Okay, so the organic molecule which has some charge, now it is known as intermediate. And this intermediate is carbocation. For example, if you have CH3 and you have magnesium, now you will tell me, where will be the tail? Tail will be at the single bond. Yes, guys? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Lithium, na? And the head will be on magnesium or carbon. What do you think? You don't know. You can't decide. Tell me.
Sir, magnesium.
Head will be on magnesium. Magnesium is a what? Metal, non-metal? Magnesium is a?
Non-metal.
अरे अच्छा एक ट्रिक आपको हम बता देते हैं. IUM जिसमें भी हो ना, if it ends with IUM, it will be a metal. But the reverse is not true. Okay, all metal don't end with IUM, but every IUM is a metal. So tell me, magnesium is a metal, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Group two, metal.
Yes, sir.
Alkaline earth metal.
Yeah.
Metal. Yeah. And metal has a tendency to? Metal has a tendency to? नहीं याद, भूल गए. Metal has the tendency to lose electron, na? Yes or no, guys? Metal has the tendency to?
Gain electron,
lose electron. हम तो बोल ही रहे हैं. आप लोग सब भूल गए. Chapter 3, revise कीजिए. Chapter 3, lose electron. That is why what will happen? The arrow will go here and this carbon will be now CH3 negative. This is known as carbon ion. Plus Cl negative, Mg positive. चलिए इतना लिखिए, आज के लिए इतना ही.
Done, sir.
All of you are done?
Sir, writing the last part.
Okay.
Done, sir.
I'm just wait a second. All of you are using a laptop?
Yes, sir.